गुड इवनिंग, नमस्कार। वेलकम टू बीएसएचएफ वेबिनार सीरीज 1 टॉक 22। आई वुड लाइक टू इनवाइट ऑर्गेनाइजर डॉक्टर ब्रह्मा सिंह, पद्मश्री अवार्डी, चेयरमैन बीएसएचएफ न्यू दिल्ली। सर प्लीज।
थैंक यू मिस्टर शिव एंड हिज सपोर्ट टीम। फ्रेंड्स नमस्कार। वी आर स्टार्टिंग टुडे विद अ सैड नोट। वी हैव लॉस्ट टॉप मोस्ट राइस मैन ऑफ इंडिया, पद्म भूषण डॉक्टर महादेवप्पा, फॉर्मर चेयरमैन एग्रीकल्चर साइंटिस्ट रिक्रूटमेंट बोर्ड न्यू दिल्ली ऑन 4th March 2021। आई ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ BSHF एंड माय ऑन पर्सनल बिहाफ विश हिम हेवनली अवार्ड। His contributions, I think country can never forget. The rice, plenty of rice what we have, he contributed a lot to that. Now coming to the webinar, as some of you know that Professor Brahm Singh Horticulture Foundation, BSHF in short, Delhi, is engaged in disseminating modern horticulture technology through webinars. Accordingly, BSHF is making efforts to disseminate knowledge on vegetable for the benefit of society, scientists, and students. This webinar series is on vegetables for nutrition and entrepreneurship, and part of the celebration of International Year of Fruits and Vegetables 2021 is International Year of Fruits and Vegetables. In this series, 21 topics mainly on nutrition and entrepreneurship of vegetables have been covered with the appreciation from participants. Eminent speakers have delivered detailed talks. These talks are full of information on nutrition in vegetable crops and entrepreneurship. All the delivered talks are available on YouTube and other popular media. BSHF is being obliged, luckily, by experts on vegetable crops with rich practical experience on the topic of the talk. They are sharing their experience and knowledge with great interest and dedication. BSHF simply salutes them and their decades-long vast knowledge and experience on the important subject. Today, the talk number 22 is on legume vegetables for nutrition and entrepreneurship. The important legume vegetables are peas and beans. They are known for their richness in protein carbohydrates. Details on these, including their nutrition value and potential for entrepreneurship, you would know in an hour-long talk by respected Dr. Agora TS, principal scientist and HR PME at Division of Vegetable Crops at Indian Council of Agriculture Research, Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore. He would be introduced by my colleague, Dr. Pritam Kalia. As you all know, Dr. Pritam Kalia is former Emeritus Scientist and Head Division of Vegetable Science at Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi. He is ICAR Rafi Ahmed Kidwai Awardee. He would also be moderating the webinar. Friends, online questions are welcome. I request Dr. Pitam Kalia ji to introduce the speaker of the day.
Thank you, sir. Good evening, everybody. It's indeed my pleasure to introduce today's speaker, called as the legume vegetable breeder, Dr. T.S. Aghora, who has had his graduation, master's and PhD degree in vegetable crops with specialization in vegetable breeding from University of Agriculture Sciences at Bengaluru. Dr. Aghora joined ICR-IAHR during 1989 after having clicked ARS and has served so far for 32 years continuously at IAHR. Dr. Aghora has experience in breeding leguminous vegetables, especially French bean, garden pea, cowpea, dolichos bean, and has released as many as 30 high yielding varieties and also disease resistant varieties, including in 30 varieties, which has been notified by Central Variety Release Committee after having assessed or evaluated through AICRP vegetable crops. Dr. Aghora has guided 8 MSc students and 3 PhD students. Besides, he has published more than 50 research papers in national and international journals of repute. Dr. Aghora was the Secretary of Society for Promotion of Horticulture, and presently he is Vice President of BEST HORT, which is a business incubation facility at Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bengaluru. For his commendable work, Dr. Aghora has been awarded a gold medal for his PhD. And he has also earned Best Paper Award in many symposia and seminars. He was organizing secretary of International Symposium on Horticulture during 2017. And presently, he is principal scientist in the Division of Vegetable Crops at IAHR. And besides, he is holding charge of PME cell at Indian Institute of Horticulture Research. So with that detail of Dr. Aghora, without standing much between speaker and the viewers, I invite Dr. T.S. Aghora to deliver his very valuable protein-rich talk to our viewers. I invite Dr. Aghora to do justice, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Am I audible to all the speakers?
Yeah.
Okay. At the outset, I'm thankful to Dr. Brahm Singh Horticulture Foundation for bestowing confidence in me and asking me to give this talk on legume vegetables for human nutrition and entrepreneurship. Respected Professor Padma Shri awardee Dr. Brahm Singh ji, Professor Pritam Kalia ji, and dear participants, I shall start my talk by giving the quote of Dr. M.S. Swaminathan about the vegetables. Very important, due to rich content of vitamins, fibers, minerals, and antioxidants, horticulture produce holds great nutritional significance, and also horticulture can alone solve the malnutrition, undernutrition, and hidden hunger problems of India. This is what the great Dr. Swaminathan has emphasized on vegetables. It is the only solution for Idan hunger. As the year of fruits and vegetables, International Year of Fruits and Vegetables, the topic selected by BSHF is excellent. That is vegetables for human nutrition and entrepreneurship. Under this, I have been asked to give a talk on legume vegetables for human nutrition and entrepreneurship. I shall be thankful to all the organizers for giving me this opportunity. I shall go ahead with my presentation of legume vegetables for human nutrition and entrepreneurship. I shall be sharing my presentation. I think my presentation is visible to all the participants.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. See, the topic is legume vegetables for human nutrition and entrepreneurship. Legume vegetables play a very major role as far as improving the fertility also of the soil and also to give the better nutrition to the human health. Among these legume vegetables, as Professor Brahmsingh has already mentioned, garden pea and French bean are very, very important. Apart from garden pea and French bean, we have vegetable cowpea, we have vichia faba, that is broad bean, we have winged bean, we have dolichos bean, that is labla purpureans, we have cluster bean, and we have soybean, vegetable soybean. And I shall be telling about the importance of these legume vegetables. These are mainly grown for their tender green pods or green seeds, either for fresh consumption or for processing as canned, frozen, or freeze-dried product. They improve the soil fertility by fixing atmospheric nitrogen. Why it is required in any of the cropping system? They are short stature crop and also very short duration. The importance of the legume vegetables is short duration. By 45 to 50 days, they start giving the pods. By 70 to 80 days, the crop will be over. They can fix this atmospheric nitrogen to the tune of 30 to 85 kg per hectare, whereas some of the legumes like cowpea and dolichos can fix atmospheric nitrogen to more than 100 kg per hectare. There they have got the role in improving the soil fertility. They are suitable for any of the cropping system because of their short duration and stature. And most importantly, as far as nutrition is concerned, they are nutritionally rich because of the low glycemic index. This is most important thing. Mostly, India might become the diabetic capital of the world. These are the things which have to be used to reduce this diabetes. Low glycemic index is one important thing which are there in the legumes, which can reduce the type 2 diabetes, which can prevent the type 2 diabetes, and to some extent, the certain cancers and cardiovascular diseases also can be reduced by these legume vegetables. This is the report by Linus Pauling Institute of Oregon State University. Coming to the area and production, how much of the area legume vegetables are grown? In India, it is around 9.7 lakh hectares and it amounts to around 9.4% of the total vegetable area. And the production is only 5.15%. That is, the productivity is very, very low. Here, breeders have the role to improve the varieties, rather release the varieties which have got high productivity. And as we look at the data, French bean, the productivity is 9.9 tons. Whereas there are certain varieties which have been bred which have got 20 tons per hectare. Vegetable cowpea, 15 to 20 tons per hectare. Garden pea, around 12 to 15 tons per hectare varieties are there. Here, we have got the role, the improved varieties have to be introduced. Some of the important legume vegetables are French bean. As I mentioned, it is Phaseolus vulgaris. The chromosome number is, diploid number is 22. Garden pea is another important legume vegetable, Pisum sativum. Here we have got Pisum sativum variety Artensis, variety arvensis and also variety macrocarpum. Variety artensis is a green pea type or garden pea type, whereas macrocarpon is a whole pod edible pea. Dalicas bean, Labla purpureus, it has got two types. One is typicus, another one is lignosus. Lignosus is mainly for the seed purpose, whereas typicus is for the vegetable type. Then we have got Simopsis tetragonoloba cluster bean, 2N is equal to 14. Then in cowpea, we have got two types. One is unguiculata types, 2N is equal to 22. These are bush types and parts are vegetable podded and also pulse types. That is dual purpose types. Whereas Vigna unguiculata subspecies sesquipedalis, it is yard long bean type. It is for the vegetable types. We have vegetable soybean, Glycin Max, 2N is equal to 20. Winged bean, Sopocarpus tetragonolobus, 2N is equal to 18. And faba bean, that is nothing but broad bean, where 2N is equal to 22, Vichia faba. Coming to the very important legume vegetable, French bean, where 2N is equal to 22, it is a very short duration crop. The crop will be over by 70 days. There are two types of French bean. One is bush type, another one is pole type. Pole type will take around 90 to 100 days, whereas bush types will take around 65 to 70 days, the crop will be over. These, in case of French bean, the tender parts and immature seeds are consumed as vegetable. Among these legume vegetables, the French beans have the highest antioxidant capacity because of significantly higher level of total phenols, ascorbic acid and beta carotenes. It is rich in proteins, calcium, phosphorus and iron. If you look at the variability in French beans, we will find purple types, green types, red types, yellow types, green with purple shade and green with purple string, like that. Lot of variability is there. This variability represents, in fact, the nutritive ability also. If you look into this purple types, they have got high antioxidants and high anthocyanin pigments. Whereas red types have got high of lycopene contents, carotenoids. Then, whereas yellow types, xanthophylls are more. Like that, there is a lot of variability exists in the nature in French beans, and which has to be harnessed. Coming to the nutritional components of French bean, it is parts are rich in proteins, 1.7 to 2.5 grams. If you take the seeds, the protein percentage is around 25 to 28%. They are rich in dietary fiber, 2.7 grams, iron, phosphorus, various minerals they are rich. And at the same time, they are rich in various vitamins, vitamin A, vitamin B complex, folic acid, vitamin B6, that is pyridoxine. It is rich in vitamins and also in minerals and also dietary fiber. If you look into the health benefits of consuming French beans, these French beans have got antioxidants like carotenoids and flavonoids. Carotenoids mainly luteins, beta carotene, violoxanthin and neoxanthin. These will give the resistance against the infectious diseases and scavenge the reactive oxygen to nullify the free radicals. If you look at the flavonoids, we see quercetin, chemophorol, catechins, epicatechins and procyanidins. These are the different flavonoids which are present in French bean, which will impart the resistance against the infectious diseases. Coming to the dietary fiber, it is rich in dietary fiber. This dietary fiber acts as laxative that helps to protect the mucous membrane of the colon by decreasing its exposure to toxins. These dietary fibers reduces the blood cholesterol levels by decreasing the reabsorption of cholesterol binding acids in the colon. The soluble fiber slows down the metabolism of carbohydrates, which in turn regulates the blood sugar levels and prevents the sudden jump in blood sugar after meals. It is good for diabetic people and those with insulin resistance. Apart from those things, it has got zeaxanthin, which helps in preventing the age-related eye diseases. It is the French bean is rich in folates, that is folic acid. The folate helps in preventing neural tube defects in the growing fetus and prevents the accumulation of an intermediary metabolite of protein metabolism called homocysteine. If homocysteine levels are high in any individual, it leads to atherosclerosis, whereas the folates or the folic acids present in French bean can reduce the production of the homocysteines. It is rich in copper. It lowers the risk of rheumatoid arthritis and maintains the elasticity of the blood. It is rich in magnesium. It helps in relieving the fatigue, relaxing sore muscles, nerves and blood vessels, thereby relieving the symptoms of asthma and migraine headaches. Coming to the therapeutic properties of French bean, it has anti-diabetic property. Alpha amylase inhibitors present in French bean slows the absorption of carbohydrates through the inhibition of enzymes responsible for digestion. In fact, alpha amylase inhibitors, if they are present in higher quantity, it might lead to loose motions also. Therefore, limited quantity of these French beans have to be taken, around 100 grams per day. Even though 300 grams of vegetables are recommended by National Institute of Nutrition, around 100 grams can be supplemented with legume vegetables. This French bean has got anti-hyperlipidemia property also. This baked and cooked beans have got the capacity to lower the cholesterol levels, and it has got anti-cancerous properties. For example, dimeric 64 kilodalton glucosamine specific lectin, if it is purified from the seeds of French bean, it exhibited anti-proliferative activity towards breast cancer, hepatoma cancer, and nasopharyngeal cancer. This is how these French beans have got anti-cancerous properties. Coming to the next important crop, garden pea, Picum sativum, 2N is equal to 14. It is highly nutritive vegetable containing high percentage of digestible proteins, carbohydrates, fats, along with minerals and vitamins too. It contains good amount of soluble and insoluble fiber and contains low cholesterol at all. Here there are two types. One is, I already mentioned that garden pea, it is Picum sativum variety Artensis. One more is there, Picum sativum variety Macrocarpum. Macrocarpum is a snap pea type or a whole pod edible pea type. This whole pod edible pea type is a novel type. This in high-end hotels, this is being served, and it fetches very high price in the market. Coming to the nutritional aspects of these things, in fact, garden pea will have better nutritional aspects than compared to the snap pea. But snap peas are high in sugar content. Coming to the other nutrient aspects, these, especially garden pea, is rich in folates. Peas are also good in many other essential B complex vitamins such as pantothenic acid, niacin, thiamine, and pyridoxine. Peas are rich source of critical cardioprotective vitamin B, that is choline. Up to 41 mg it is there. Polyphenol called comestrol, which decreases the risk of stomach cancers. If we just look at the nutritional components of pea, it is rich in protein, 7.2 grams, and dietary fiber. And it has got almost all the vitamins, vitamin B complex, vitamin A, and several minerals in a higher quantity. Coming to the phytochemicals in garden pea, I've already mentioned that catechin and epicatechin are the flavonoids which are present in garden pea. They prevent the inflammatory bowel disease. As with respect to carotenoids, it has got alpha carotene and beta carotenes. Alpha carotene will lower the risk of cardiovascular diseases, whereas beta carotene prevents the eye diseases. It also has got various phenolic acids. Phenolic acids like ferulic acid and caffeic acid. It will help in skin integrity, and also they prevent cancer, premature aging. They act as antioxidants. It reduces the exercise-related fatigue. It also has got polyphenols like comestrol. This comestrol reduces the bone loss and promotes mineralization of the bones. Apart from this, we have anti-inflammatory phytonutrients in case of garden pea like Picum, saponin 1 and 2, and Pyosmocytes A and B. They are again anti-carcinogenic, anti-diabetic, and hepatoprotective, that is liver protective. And they are rich in omega-3 fatty acids. And this omega-3 fatty acids is alpha-linolenic acid, and it prevents heart and blood vessel diseases. I have already mentioned that folic acid is very much present in garden pea, and it helps to prevent the neural tube defects in the newborn babies. I mentioned about one important vitamin B, that is choline, that is critical cardioprotective. Ascorbic acid, as you all know, it helps to develop resistance against infectious diseases. Even during COVID-19, vitamin C is the one which has been administered, and it scavenges the harmful and pro-inflammatory free radicals. We have an important phytosterol in garden pea, that is cytosterol, beta-cytosterol. It lowers the cholesterol levels, and it is rich in phylloquinones, that is vitamin K, which helps in preventing the Alzheimer's disease by limiting the neuronal damage in the brain. In fact, pea leaves, which are rich in phylloquinones, they are found to have potential role in bone mass building function by promoting osteotropic activity in the bone. Pea leaves also can be consumed. I already mentioned about the flavonoids such as carotenes, lutein, and zeaxanthin. It is vitamin A is around 765 international units. By consuming these things, along with other natural fruits, which are rich in flavonoids, which helps to protect from lung and oral cavity cancers. Vitamin A is essential nutrient, which is required for maintaining the healthy mucous membranes and skin, and also essential for vision. Some of the garden green peas have got purple pods also. They are rich in anthocyanins. They show moderate stability and antioxidative activity. Coming to the next important crop is Dalicas bean. Dalicas bean is mainly a bean for drought tolerance. It is rich in protein, minerals, and vitamins, and it is a major source of protein for South Indian diet. It also provides nutritious green fodder to milching animals. Apart from being drought tolerant, it has high adaptability to wide range of production conditions. It also improves soil fertility. I also mentioned that it fixes the atmospheric nitrogen more than 100 kg per hectare. Freshly extracts are rich in sugar, alcohols, phenols, steroids, essential oils, alkaloids, tannins, and various pigments. Coming to the nutritional component of Dalicas bean, it is rich in carbohydrates and protein and several minerals and also folic acid. This is the variability which you can see. The variability with respect to Dalicas bean is purple types are there, light purple types are there, green types are there. These different types have got high nutrition capability. Especially these purple types have got high antioxidant properties. And in this also, there is a lot of variability with respect to nutrition. Coming to the health benefits of consuming Dalicas bean, it is rich in copper, vitamin B1, and zinc. With respect to copper, it is essential for the brain pathways such as galactose and dopamine, which helps to maintain the mood and focus. Dopamine is very important because it avoids these Alzheimer's. This is also associated in utilizing tyrosinase, ascorbate oxidase, superoxide dismutase, and vitamin C. This Dalicas beans are rich in copper. Then they are rich in vitamin B1 also, thiamine. It is vital for the production of acetylcholine, which is a neurotransmitter that relay the messages from the nerves to the muscles. Heart depends on these signals, which helps counteract heart diseases as it maintains the healthy ventricular function and treats heart failure. Dalika's beans are rich in zinc. It has antioxidant and anti-inflammatory properties, which helps to counteract oxidative stress, which prevents the mutation of the cells and prevents tumor growth. They are rich in other minerals also, manganese, reduce the oxidative stress and heal the lungs. And as usual, Dalika's bean is also rich in fiber. Insoluble fiber helps to prevent bloating, constipation and indigestion. Soluble fiber helps in digestion by absorbing the water to form a viscous substance which is fermented by the bacteria in a digestive tract. It is rich in magnesium also. It reduces the symptoms of insomnia, improves sleep time and sleep efficiency. It also reduces the cortisols. Dalika's is one vegetable which is rich in vitamin D also. It reduces the gum inflammation that is related with periodontal gum disease. And it has potassium of 262 mg, which reduces the muscle cramps and improves the strength of the muscles. Some of the traditional uses of Dalika's, if you look at, in Malaysia, the leaves are used with rice flour and turmeric as a poultice for eczema. Poultice is nothing but a paste. This, by making the paste of these leaves, they use it for eczema. An infusion made from the leaves is used to treat the gonorrhea also. In Indochina, these leaves of Dalika's has been used for colic pain. In East Africa, crushed leaves are used to cure headache. Green leaves with vinegar used to cure the snake bites. Now, I really do not know to what extent it treats the snake bites, but anyway, it is being used in East Africa. In Rwanda, decoction made from the leaves is used to cure the heart problems. In Democratic Republic of Congo, an infusion made from the leaves is used to treat the sore throat and tonsillitis. The leaves are taken and they will make an infusion and it treats the sore throat. In Asia, flowers are used as antivenous, alexithric and carminative, that is against the allergy. The flowers are used. In Assam, pot juice is used to treat inflammation of the ear and throat. Chinese, they use these leaves use the boiled ripe seeds as a carminative and tonic. In India, it is known that seeds are used to stop nose bleeding. In Senegal, seed is used to stomachache, antispasmodic and as a treatment for sunstroke and cholera. These are traditional uses of Dalika's bean. Coming to the therapeutic properties of Dalika's bean, it has anti-diabetic property, anti-anemic property and hypolipidemic effect and anti-lithiatic effect. Coming to the anti-diabetic effect, the methanol extracts of Dalika's pods, by the Dalika's pods are used to extract the methanol extracts of Dalika's pods have got anti-hyperglycemic property by way of reducing the blood glucose levels. It has anti-anemic effect also. It increases the hemoglobin level and hematocrit level. Then hypolipidemic effect, it reduces the plasma cholesterol. Then it also prevents the formation of the kidney stones or relieves the symptoms of kidney stones. This is with respect to Dalika's bean. In fact, Dalika's beans, the colored ones have got some anti-nutrients also. The anti-nutrients like cyanogens, cyanide glucosides, and these cyanide glucosides or cyanogens by boiling or by selecting the white seeded types, we can get rid of those anti-nutrients. Coming to another important legume vegetable which has got high nutrition is vegetable cowpea and yardlang bean. This vegetable cowpea is Vigna unguiculata, subspecies unguiculata, whereas yardlang bean is subspecies escupedalis. Again, it is a short duration drought resistant crop. It produces more foliage and covers ground. Thus, it prevents the soil erosion. Pods and seeds are highly nutritious, rich in protein, calcium, phosphorus, iron, carotene, thiamine and riboflavin. One particular protein is present in this cowpea. This is called as angulin, a protein isolated from cowpea. It inhibits the human immunodeficiency virus 1, that is HIV. It inhibits the multiplication of HIV virus. Angulin, that protein, has also got antifungal property. These are the different cowpea types, sesquipedalis types, and as well as vegetable cowpea types. Coming to the nutritional components of vegetable cowpea, it is rich in proteins. The pods, I am referring only about the pods. Pods are rich in proteins. And it's also rich in various minerals like phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, and to some extent they supply the vitamins also, B complex and also folates. Coming to the health benefits, as usual, because they are rich in proteins, as far as the seeds are concerned, the green seeds around 23 to 32%, and fiber. It helps in weight management, cholesterol reduction, diabetes and cancer. Low glycemic index, it helps in regulating blood sugar levels in diabetes. It has got lysine and tryptophan. It is essential for immunity, development and mood elevation. And the minerals like potassium, magnesium, calcium, phosphorus and iron, they have the role in body fluid maintenance, cardiac function, osteoporosis and blood formation. It has got protein inhibitor, that is Baumann-Birch protease inhibitor, which is responsible for anti-proliferative activity and therefore control certain types of cancer. Mainly antioxidants, that is carotenoids, are present. Light brown, red and black cowpea varieties are rich in antioxidants. They will prevent the aging process. These yard-long beans are rich in dietary fiber. It helps to protect the colon mucosa by reducing its exposure time to toxic substances. It reduces the LDL cholesterol levels by decreasing the reabsorption of the cholesterols. Again, this yardlong bean is rich in folates, and also with vitamin B12, it is essential for DNA synthesis and cell division. It prevents the neuron tube defects in the newborns. It is mainly recommended for pregnant women. Vitamin C rich, it helps to build the immunity to combat infections and contribute to maintain the blood vessel elasticity and offer some protection against cancer. And again, it is rich in manganese. The body uses manganese as a cofactor for the important antioxidant enzyme superoxide dismutase. Then another important legume vegetable, which is referred as one species supermarket. This is nothing but Sopocarpus tetragonoloba. It is winged bean. In this winged bean, almost all the parts are consumed, whether it is leaves or the green parts or the flowers or the immature seeds, the tubers, the mature seeds, all are consumed as in one or the other way. These seeds contain high dietary protein due to their amino acid content and substantial protein bioavailability. Thus, this winged bean is a very rich source of human nutrition. Carbohydrates up to 41.7 grams, whereas dietary fiber is very rich, 25.9 grams. Protein is 29.65 grams. Apart from that, there are various minerals and vitamins are present. Tryptophan present in winged beans, it alleviates the pain related with tension headaches and migraines, and also help in curing the nausea and sleep problems. Copper, again strong antioxidant that works in the presence of the antioxidant enzyme superoxide dismutase to safeguard the cell membranes from free radicals. Manganese cures sprains and inflammation by increasing the same enzyme. Thiamine, it helps to defend against vision problems like cataract and glaucoma. It is rich in fiber, I already mentioned. It aids in digestion and preventing constipation. Phosphorus remove minor health problems like muscle weakness and numbness, fatigue. It is rich in calcium, has direct effect on the pancreatic cells that control insulin secretion and therefore blood sugar levels. Magnesium rich, it cures chronic asthma by normalizing the breathing by relaxing the bronchial muscles. And this winged bean is rich in zinc too, helps in fighting the colds and symptoms of illness. Coming to the traditional uses of winged bean, the roots of winged bean are used as poultice, that is soft moist mass, to treat vertigo, and leaves are used in the treatment of smallpox. Pods and edible tubers are considered as tonic. It is a roborant and it is consumed. Pod extract is used to treat boils and ulcers. Bean seed extract show radical scavenging, antimicrobial and antioxidant activities. Another important legume vegetable which is used as a vegetable is vegetable soybeans, which differ from regular soybeans in many ways. Vegetable soybean has got a double the protein content, that is around 22% when compared to the normal this one, and 6 times the energy content of the green peas, with 60% more calcium and twice the phosphorus and potassium levels. These vegetable soybeans are usually large seeded with mild taste, tender and easily digestible. The tender green seeds are consumed as vegetable here. Here, harvesting vegetable soybean at the right time is critical for maximum texture and flavor because of the loss of quality occurs when pods turn yellow. We have to harvest at the green stage itself. The quality is best when the pods are plump and bright green, similar to snow peas. Coming to the vegetable soybean compared to the mature soybean, the folate content is 78%, whereas in mature soybean, normal soybean, it is 14%. Vitamin K1 33%, thiamine is 13%. In fact, vegetable soybeans are very rich in nutrients with respect to vitamins, minerals, and folic acid. It has got high content of beta conglycinin. It increases the specific protein levels in the blood, which can turn into, in turn, result in improved metabolism. And it is rich in omega-3 fatty acids. Vegetable soybeans are rich in omega-3 fatty acids, which known to help with heart disease and can reduce the risk of stroke. The fiber in the soybeans can also reduce the cholesterol levels. Then these vegetable soybeans are rich in isoflavones also. They are essential components of the female reproductive system. Isoflavones in soybean can help to protect against the spinal bone loss. It is rich in oligosaccharides, known to help stimulate the production of healthy bacteria in the intestines, thus serving as a great source of prebiotics. Hypotensive properties it has got, it helps in reducing the blood sugar, blood pressure. And it has insulin receptors, helps in prevention and management of diabetes, primarily because they have shown an ability to increase the insulin receptors in the body. Magnesium is another important component or nutrition in vegetable soybean. It helps in reducing the sleep disorders and the occurrence of insomnia. Another important legume vegetable which has got industry value is cluster bean. This is Simopsis tetragonoloba, 2N is equal to 14. It is a rich source of protein, fats, carotenes, phosphorus, calcium and mineral salts which are needed for the human body. And also it serves as a feed for the animals. The seeds of the cluster bean contains about 30 to 33% of the gum in the endosperm. This gum has got a very important component, that is galactomannan. It is a polysaccharide which has got molecular weight of 50,000 to 8 lakh units. The molecular weight is 50,000 to 8 lakh. And thus, it is very, very important in the industry. Apart from using this as a gaur gum, it is also used as a vegetable at tender stage in southern parts of India. And the cluster bean has got dietary fiber of 2.5 grams and various minerals and also protein to the extent of 4 grams. The nutritive compounds of iron, glyconutrients, phosphorus and calcium, these will help again in reducing the chances of anemia, and it enhances the hemoglobin content within RBCs and enhances the oxygen consumption capacity in the blood, and thus enhances the better blood circulation. Glyconutrients control the blood sugar levels. Phosphorus and calcium enhances the bone health. Then they have got again the folic acid. This folic acid is vital for pregnant women, and hypoglycemic and hypolipidemic compounds are also present in cluster beans. They are the natural aids for people suffering from hypertension. As diabetes and heart disease increase risk of hypertension, the combined effect of these compounds play an important role in controlling the blood pressure. These cluster beans are rich in vitamin K. It helps to reduce the normal development of fetus and reduce any birth complications. Another important vegetable, legume vegetable, is broad bean, Vicia faba, where 2N is equal to 12. It is used as a high protein food, and it is popular in Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. Large seeded varieties are often used as a green vegetable. Large seeded varieties, they are green and they are used as vegetable. Value addition is in the form of canning is being done. Again, it is rich in protein, very rich in carbohydrates and various minerals. And the compounds from broad bean, we can extract L-DOPA and carbidopa, which reduce the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. Glutathione, it strengthens the immune system and it delays the aging of the cell as they combat the free radicals. As usual, the iron, it reduces the symptoms of anemia, but people with a rare genetic condition known as glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase, you have to avoid raw broad bean consumption because it may cause favism, which is a type of anemia. It might cause favism. Therefore, it may be a precaution may be taken while consumption of faba bean. It is also rich in fiber. It helps to lose the weight and reduces the calorie consumption, and it promotes the feeling of fullness. Magnesium and potash maintains the blood pressure level. And again, it is rich in folic acid. It reduces the occurrence of congenital anomalies in the fetus, and very rich in many minerals, maintains the bone health and enhances the bone strength. These are very important aspects of the nutrition. Coming to the role of legume vegetables in entrepreneurship, one important thing is quality seed production. If you look at the market size of the Indian seed industry, it is around 7,000 crores. Out of which, vegetable seed industry itself is around 1,000 crores. It is around 14.3%. If you look at the vegetable legume seeds, it is around 200 crores market size. There is so much of scope for taking up the seed production as an entrepreneurship. Apart from this, value addition is another thing. Some of the legumes like garden pea are frozen, processed into frozen peas, canned peas. And out of the total Indian frozen vegetable sale, frozen peas amounts to 75%. I shall come to that. Coming to the seed requirement of the legume vegetables, the total area, it is around 9 lakh hectares. The total seed requirement is around 6,900 tons in French bean, 16,800 tons in peas, 1,200 tons in vegetable dalikas, and 2,700 tons in vegetable dalikas. Rather, 1,200 tons in vegetable cowpea and 2,700 tons in dalikas. But if you take 30% as the seed replacement rate, it comes to around 8,280 tons of actual seed requirement annually. 8,280 tons, if you keep the seed price, it will be around 205 crores market size of the vegetable legume seeds. And it is very, very easy because of the crop itself is self-pollinated, and it is, the seed production is very easy. At ICRIHR, more than 35 varieties have been released. In French bean, we have released 6 varieties, pole type 1 variety, garden pea 12 varieties, dalicas bean 5, dalicas bean pole type 8 varieties. These are all photo insensitive varieties. Cowpea, vegetable cowpea 3 varieties, yard long bean 1 variety. Totally 36 varieties at ICRIHR we have released. Apart from that, at IAVR, several varieties of French bean, garden pea, dalicas bean and cowpea have been released. Kerala Agriculture University has released several varieties in yard long bean, Vaijayanti, then several varieties, Lola, like that the varieties have been released. IRA has released many varieties in French bean. The contender is first variety, garden pea, Arkel has been released, Bonvilla has been released. In other than that, in Pantnagar, several varieties have been released, like Anupama. And coming to different varieties which have been released, which are ready for seed production, or Arka Arjun, it has got resistance to virus, mung bean yellow mosaic virus. Arka Sharad, this is another variety which is a ring bean type. This is also ready for seed production. Arka Sukomal, it is a pole type bean. This Arka Anup, it has got resistance to rust and as well as bacterial blight, which is available for seed production. Arka Suvidha is a stringless pair type. Arka Bold, it is a flat podded stringless type. It is resistant to rust and as well as bacterial blight. These varieties are can be taken up for seed production. Apart from French bean, we have various garden pea varieties. They are high temperature tolerant varieties like Chaitra, Uttam and Tapas. These varieties can also be taken up for seed production. These can tolerate the temperature up to 38 degrees Celsius. Then Arka Priya, Ajit and Karthik, these are powder mildew resistant varieties. Arka Pramod is powder mildew resistant variety. Arka Apurva is another novel type variety that we have already mentioned about this variety. It is a whole pod edible type. This is Pisum sativum variety macrocarpum. This is a novel type which has got high demand in high-end hotels. Then another drought-tolerant crop is dalicas. Here also several photo-insensitive bush dalicas and as well as pole dalicas have been developed. These are also very much available for seed production. Then cowpea varieties. From IRA also cowpea varieties have been released, Pusa Barsati, Pusa Dofasli. From IHR, Arka Samruddhi, Arka Mangala, Arka Suman, Arka Garima, these have been released. If you look at the seed production and with that of vegetable production, vis-a-vis vegetable production, by growing vegetables in 1 acre, the farmers, we have conducted this one in 2013 to 2018. We have given the seed production to around 80 farmers. And with earlier vegetable production, the farmer used to get around 44 to 45,000 per acre. By adopting the seed production, his income has doubled, around 85 to 90,000 per acre. There is 94% increased income as compared to the commercial vegetable production has been observed. See, coming to scope for processing in garden pea, the one important thing is production we can take up, seed production. Another one is processing of garden pea we can take up. Coming to the garden pea processing, it is mainly processed into canned pea or frozen peas. Urban consumers in India have been increasing consumption of frozen processed food. In our country, only 2.2% of the produce is processed in India, whereas in Philippines, it is 78%. In China, it is 23%. In USA, it is 65%. If you look at the demand, see, the size of Indian frozen vegetable market is 9,219 tons. Out of the total Indian frozen vegetable sale, frozen peas alone is 75%, that is around 6,915 tons. So much of scope is there for frozen peas. The fresh peas are available only during winter, but are generally required in all the seasons. Therefore, there this frozen peas will come for the meeting the demand. This gap of will be met by the frozen peas. If you look at the export of processed legume vegetables from India, during 2019-20, the quantity of the peas, dried shelled peas and split peas are exported to the tune of 3,174 tons, metric tons, worth 8.89 crores. Whereas vegetable cowpea is worth 21.17 crores, whereas French bean is around 18.56 crores. Major importing countries are USA, UK, Germany, and Thailand. The people can think in terms of export also to become entrepreneurship. Coming to another important another important aspect is cluster bean gum or gaur gum. It is one thing which has been used in food emulsifier, food additive, food thickener and other gaur gum products. It is mainly because of the unique binding property of gaur gum, and it has got the property of thickening and emulsifying quality of the gaur gum powder, which gained the importance in the international market. The consumption of gaur gum by oil drilling industry was limited to around 30%. But at present, the scenario has changed and the major consumer of gaur gum is from oil drilling industry, while the demand from food industry has reduced to around 20%. Earlier, food industry was taking 50% of the gaur gum, but now it is reduced to 20%. But the oil drilling industries, they are taking more. What is this gaur gum? This gaur gum is the ground endosperm of the seeds from cluster bean, mainly consisting of high molecular weight polysaccharide, that is galactomannans, that is, as I mentioned, 50,000 to 8 lakh units. And this mannose to galactose ratio is about 2:1. The seeds are crushed to eliminate the germ. The endosperm is dehusked, milled and screened to obtain the ground endosperm, that is native gaur gum. The gum may be washed with ethanol or isopropanol to control the microbiological load, and it becomes the washed gaur gum. It is mainly because of the good solubility. This native gaur gum, or the demand for Indian gaur gum, is mainly because of the good solubility, good thickening and good hydrogen binding property. There is so much of demand in the international market. Coming to the gaur gum export, how much is being exported? And it is exported, rather, the various importing countries are USA, Russia, Germany, Norway, China, Australia, Netherlands, Canada, and UK. During 2020-21, 1.54 lakh tons of gaur gum was exported to these countries, worth 1,204 crores. There is very big market size. During 2020-21, the export is reduced when compared to 1920 and 1819, mainly because of the COVID restrictions. Otherwise, the market size is around 4,000 crores. Though these legumes have got very high nutritional content for the human beings, they do have got anti-nutritional factors. Some of the anti-nutritional factors are phagolins, phytic acids, trypsin inhibitors, then cyanide glucosides and cyanogens, and in case of broad bean, tannins, and all these things are anti-nutrients. That is one of the reasons why more quantity of these legume vegetables are not consumed as a seed form. If you consume some of the varieties which are white seeded types, there the anti-nutrient content will be very, very less. Apart from that, when these legume vegetables are boiled and consumed, it will remove the anti-nutrient factors. Friends, coming to the conclusion, legume vegetables are must for any cropping system. You know why it is so? Because of their capacity to fix the atmospheric nitrogen. They produce the quality protein, vitamins and minerals required for normal growth and development. There are several opportunities to become an entrepreneur by taking up seed production or value addition or export. Here I just want to give an example of one seed company, Ashoka Seeds. It is located in Bangalore. There, their turnover by only legume seeds is around 15 crores. From total vegetables, it is 60 crores. And from vegetables alone, it is 15 crores annually. I had discussion with this proprietor of this company. He was telling from Arka Komal alone, the turnover is around 3 to 4 crores annually. This is the potentiality of the legume vegetables. I have to acknowledge the BSHF for having given me this opportunity, Padmashri awardee, Professor Brahmsingh Ji, and I also should acknowledge Professor Pritam Kalia Ji, my director, Dr. Dinesh, my colleague, Dr. Nagangaud Patil, and Dr. Tangam for their support in preparing this presentation. Thank you so much. Thanks for your patient hearing. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Dr. Agora.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Pritam Kalia, would you like to moderate?
Yes, sir.
Ashif, find out if some questions are there. Be ready.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Friends, I think you will agree that we have had very nice, very protein-rich presentation. Protein-rich presentation that we have had is important, as we know that protein-related malnutrition in the country is also very prominent, though the first and foremost nutrient is vitamin A. Malnutrition is prevalent, but protein malnutrition in the lower strata of the society is very prominent. And this today's talk is very much protein rich, although the general public knows that the proteins we get from pulses only. But I always speak whenever there is a talk on vegetables that the vegetable legumes are the most wanted crops from the protein point of view, because here we have absorbable soluble protein which are readily available, bioavailable to the consumers, compared to that of pulses where mostly we have crude proteins. So there is the importance of vegetable legumes as a protein rich vegetables and the source or to counter malnutrition problem that our country faces, and in general the Asia faces. And well, friends, we have had 9 vegetables, legume vegetables talked about by Dr. Agora, out of which 3 with the diploid chromosome as 22, 3 with the diploid chromosome as 14, 1 with the diploid chromosome as 20, 1 with diploid chromosome as 15.
Talked about by Dr. Agora, out of which 3 with the
and 1 with the 12 chromosome as winter bean or a broad bean that has been talked about. Dr. Agora has given a detailed profile of nutrition of all these vegetable crops and the variability with respect to the nutrients in all the crops which has been shown. And this, just 1 minute. We have had that Dr. Agora has shown with respect to various nutrient in all these 9 crops gives us the confidence that the further enhancement or densing of these nutrients is possible through breeding program which gives us importance, as the importance has been highlighted from health benefits point of view and industrial benefit point of view. So if we further develop the nutrient, those nutrient dense varieties which will be suitable for the fresh market as well as for processing, as also for the industry from the pharmaceutical importance point of view. So those part has been dealt in very detail, and I hope that viewers must have been benefited with this. And the range of the crops that he has shown that importance of these crops from their plant growth habit point of view, their suitability from a short duration point of view, fitting into different cropping systems, that enhances the benefits or the profitability of the farmers, increasing cropping intensity, improving the soil health, and reducing the requirement of nitrogen especially. So that adds to the input reduction cost of the farmers, as well as because when you use them, these crops in intercropping system or with other crops in conjunction, the requirement of nitrogen of other crops also gets reduced. And the value of these crops from the point of view that the entrepreneurship also, he has highlighted very nicely that these are large seed volume required crops. So the seed production is itself a big business, and as he has very much highlighted that production of seed can enhance the income of the farmers to a great extent, and is already doing so. There is a possibility of further farmers taking up entrepreneurship and making the seeds available to the fellow growers within their location, as well as exporting to the other areas within the country and abroad also, as the demand increases in the native in the adjoining countries. So the from processing point of view, that a lot of possibilities, the processed traits can also be enhanced through breeding and making this sector more viable, as presently it's there in case of garden pea only, as freezing industry has increased, but there is a further possibility to enhance these aspects to a greater extent. And the content like that of guar gum in case of cluster bean, in some of the crops, Dr. Ghora mentioned that for South India, but nowadays the society is vibrant. People are moving to the north and north to south. So the requirement of the crops, which earlier were location specific, now they are required across the country and even abroad, where the Indians move, the from export point of view, a lot of demand has come up. So the new entrepreneurship, the educated community who is coming forward, they can go for scientific cultivation of these crops, and their utilization in processed products also has a lot of demand coming up. And as also he has cautioned that there are various anti-nutrient factors which needs to be taken care of. So the quantity of consumption that has to be nominal, it has not to be in bulk so that it can cause problem. But at the same time, we need to breed varieties which are free from anti-nutritional factors through marker-assisted breeding. It's possible to get varieties which are free from anti-nutritional factors. So that part, there is a lot of scope for the new researchers to get into such type of research programs to give varieties which are nutrient rich as well as are free from anti-nutrient factors. So friends, holistically, this was a very fruitful, nutritively rich talk that we have had, and I hope the viewers must have been benefited, and it gives boost to the researchers as well as consumers as well as the entrepreneurs to further look into and flourish in this sector. So with that, I thank the Dr. Ghora, today's speaker, very much, and congratulations to Dr. Ghora for a nice talk. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for detailing the complete lecture. Thank you. In fact, my number is 998610079. Anybody who wants this PPT, I can share with them. No problem.
You have sent it to us?
Yeah, okay, I can send it to you, sir.
Sir, one question is there, sir.
Yeah, please.
Dr. Manish Singh is asking, sir, how can we increase the TSS, total soluble solid, in the pea?
Yeah, in fact, pea, you know, it has got a high percentage of TSS to the tune of around 12%. We have seen. We have to rather evaluate various lines, and we have to find. In fact, some of the local types, Magdi local types, have got high TSS. Such of those things have to be used in breeding program to increase the TSS. In fact, snow peas have got ITSS too, that is whole pod edible peas. These whole pod edible peas are the macrocarpon types. These are cross compatible with the hortensis group also. They also can be used to improve the TSS.
Okay, any other question?
All appreciation we have, sir. Sir, your photo is not coming. Please put on your camera, sir.
What will you do with my photo? Okay. anyway, I have to...
Jacket. Green jacket.
Thank Dr. Agora. Some question?
No, sir. Information on legume vegetable crops with reference to nutrition. Thank you so much, Dr. Thangam. Thank you.
Your colleague, good...
Yeah, very informative lecture.
Yes,
excellent.
Yes. Okay, okay.
Sandeep.
Sanjay Kumar Dwivedi, yes, very informative talk. He is director at Defense Research Laboratory, Tejpur.
Oh, okay, sir. Good evening, sir.
Pandavi, good evening, sir. Okay. Okay, excellent. So I have to thank Dr. Agora, though Dr. Pritam Kalyaji have nicely moderated and thanked him nicely, which he deserves for his we have to say in few words, that's what Dr. Kalia said in the beginning, the nutritive excellent talk.
Thank you so much.
Excellent talk on legume vegetables. So that's what we can say about it. And you have really worked hard to compile the literature on nutrition on these crops. Friends, yeah. Those who are listening, kindly don't take vegetables as for a item for palatability, liking, disliking, and filling the belly. By the talk of Dr. Agora, it is very clear what all they contain. It's not only the nutrition, but the therapeutic properties also he has highlighted in certain cases.
Yes.
And not only the nutrition and therapeutic properties, the business, entrepreneurship, what we have got the title of the series, entrepreneurship. He has clearly come out, what are the potential and what are going on, the entrepreneurship in these crops, citing the example, giving the figures also, very lucrative figure, impressive figures, and it's not the seed, but the value addition, and in value addition, he has clearly come out with the pea, which is becoming popular, likewise other legumes can also follow this shoot. So these legumes are very important, not from human health point of view, but the soil health point of view also, which he has clearly mentioned, the capacity or capability of some of the legumes to fix up atmospheric nitrogen in the field, different this one. And moreover, they are drought resistant. Less requirement of water. And the other agricultural practices also comparatively less. So these crops, vegetable crops, I consider them very important vegetable crops, giving us lot of nutrition, taking care of the soil health, and providing opportunity, enormous opportunity for entrepreneurship. So with these few words, I once again thank Mr. Shiv and his team, Dr. Kalyaji, for nicely moderating the talk, introducing the speaker, and what he expected, it came true. And I'm highly impressed with Dr. Agora's talk. He has really worked hard to compile all that. We are obliged, Agora Saab, with your detailed this one information on legumes, and you are kind enough, liberal also, sharing the information which you have gathered. You are a large-hearted man. Good. With these words, I congratulate you and I thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, all participants. All the participants, thank you so much. Okay, ji.
I once again thank each and every one, sir. Professor okay. Pritam Kalyaji, Professor Prem Singh. Thank you.
Welcome, okay. Welcome.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Have a nice time. Good evening.
Okay. Okay.
Thank you,
okay.
Sir. Thank you,
sir. We will meet again next Saturday. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.